Perfection. It is the product of huge number of practices. So please practice daily and be perfect with what you are. And let's get started to start a problem from Fourier transforms. And we have to show that f of x is equal to x if x lies between 0 to 1 and 2 minus x if x lies between 1 to 2 and 0 if x is greater than 2 is 2 sine s into 1 minus cos s by s square. So let's get started to find the Fourier sine transforms. So for finding Fourier sine transform, by definition we have. So by definition of Fourier sine transforms, that is, we have Fourier sine transforms as Fourier sine transform of f of x value is equal to integral 0 to infinity, this is f of x into this is sine sx into dx. So for that we have to introduce these limits as 1 and 2. So this one, that is Fourier sine transform of the function f of x is equal to integral 0 to 1 f of x into sine sx into dx plus this is 1 to 2 f of x into this is sine sx into dx and this is 2 to infinity f of x into sine sx into dx. So we have all the values here between 0 to 1. Our f of x value is x. Now I am going to substitute this one. That is the Fourier sine transforms of the function f of x is equal to integral 0 to 1. So between 0 to 1 our f of x value is x. So I am going to substitute in place of f of x as x into sine sx into dx plus integral 1 to 2. So between 1 to 2 our f of x value is 2 minus x. This is 2 minus x into sine sx into dx plus this is in between 2 to infinity, so 2 to infinity our f of x value, so greater than 2, all the values are 0, so this value is 0 into sine sx into dx. So now we have two integrals to solve, and that is Fourier sine transforms of f of x value is equal to integral 0 to 1, this is x sine sx into dx plus, so this is 1 to 2, this is 2 minus x into sine sx into dx. So we have integration by parts. This is u and this is v. This is u and this is v. So I am going to show the formula here, that is integral uv dx is nothing but u we have to leave, v we have to integrate minus integral. This is d by dx of u integral v dx whole dx. So if I apply this formula, we will get the result. That is Fourier sine transform of the function f of x is equal to. So u we have to leave as it is, x I am leaving, v I have to integrate. For sine it is minus cos sx by, for x it is 1, s remains. Minus integral derivative of u. What is the derivative of u? This is 1. And what is the integration of sine? This is minus cos sx by s between the limits. See here, between the limits is 0 to 1 and here plus. So what is u here? U is nothing but 2 minus x into v. The integration part is minus, this is cos sx. This is cos sx by s by integral. For 2 it is constant 0, for x it is 1, this is minus times of. For sine it is minus cos. That is cos sx by s of dx between the limits 1 to 2. And here we have to solve this one. For that, for cos it is again sine. See here, Fourier sine transforms of f of x value is nothing but minus s x cos sx by s and minus of minus. This is plus. For cos it is sine sx by, for x it is 1, this will be sine square between the limits. See here, between the limits 0 to 1 and next one is plus, this is minus of 2 minus x, this is cos sx by s minus, for cos it is sine, that is sine sx by x1 and s square between the limits 1 to, this is 1 to 2. Now I have to substitute upper limit minus lower limit. For that, the Fourier sine transforms of f of x value is equal to upper limit x, if I keep, see, if I keep 1 here, this will be 1 into cos s1 by s plus this is sine s1 by s square. And for lower limit, it is, for in place of x, if I keep 0, for lower limit it is 0, and this is minus, this is sine 0 by s square. And if I keep 2 here, this will be minus, this is 2 minus 2 into cos 0 by s, and later minus, this is sine 2s by s square. And if I keep 1 here, minus of minus plus, this is 2 minus 1 into cos s1 by s, and this is plus, this is sine s into 1 by s square. Here what remains here, sine 0 value is 0, as you know. So anything else here? So this is minus cos s by s. See, I'll simplify. So Fourier sine transforms of f of x value is equal to minus cos s, minus cos s by s plus this is sine s by s square, and this is 0, and this value is sine 2s by s square, and 2 minus 1 is 1 plus this is cos s by s plus this is sine s by this is s square. So I can cancel this plus and minus. So Fourier sine transform of f of x value is nothing but, see, if I take LCM here as s square, this is sine s and this is sine s. Sine s plus this is a sine s minus a sine 2s by s square. So which is equal to 2 sine s by s square minus sine 2s by s square. So which is sine transform of f of x. So we got the value of Fourier sine transform of the function f of x. If I take LCM as s square, this will be 2 sine s minus, this is a sine 2s. As you know that 2 sine s minus sine 2 theta can be written as 2 sine theta into cos theta by s square. So this is Fourier sine transform of f of x. So Fourier sine transform of f of x value is equal to, if I take this 2 sine s common, then this will be 1 minus cos s by s square. So here it is asked to show that, what it is asked to show, that the Fourier sine transformation of this function is 2 sine s into 1 minus cos s by s square. So this is 2 sine s into 1 minus cos s by s square. The Fourier sine transform of the function is 2 sine s into 1 minus cos s by s square. So this is what it is asked to show that. So thank you so much for watching and staying till the end. And there are many videos which I am going to come up very very soon. I hope that really you learned really new, and I really hope that this video is very informative. Stay connected. If you really like this video, please pass it on to your friends, and I invite your subscription. Thank you so much.